Yo, what's going on, guys? It's SMS back with NFT and me, and we are going to take a look at two free tools that will help you get a better edge and advantage on, you know, buying into a project or actually sniping off of the floor. As always, though, we are sponsored by the Lazy Hero NFT collection. If you haven't by now, I'm going to put a link in the description below. Get yourself over to magiceden, pick yourself up a Lazy Hero. The villains are coming out, the tokens coming out in the near future, and there's also comics that are down the road. So there's a lot of, you know, great things going on with this project, and it's a sleeping giant, I'm telling you guys. They've been pumping it up, and you can see their numbers are, you know, going through the roof. The more and more that you see them in spaces, the more and more people with PFPs. I mean, I'm telling you, take a look at it. Not financial advice, but you see projects where their price goes like this and it kind of stays down. This one seems to be going like this. And if you follow any kind of price action, that's bullish sentiment. So take a look, not financial advice. Also, like I said, we're gonna take a look at a couple tools today. It's Soul Radar and Soul Sniper. Soul Sniper is exactly that. It gives you an edge on, you know, sniping off of the floor. If there's a project that hits a secondary mark or market, and it's running up, the volume's going through the roof, or if there is some kind of catalyst like tokens are released and the volume starts running up, people are gonna usually take their profits at that point, or at least somebody's going to sell something and they're gonna undercut. And it gives you a live feed and shows you when that price drops down so you can snipe the floor. You actually click a button on there. I'm gonna show you that, exactly how to do that. I don't think there's any mints that I'm following right now, but we can still check it out because if there's any activity with any of these projects, it will correspond with that. So I'll try and find something that's kind of active right now, something maybe a newer collection that's being sold. Another thing is Soul Radar. Soul Radar is one of my favorites just to track the progress of the price. And, you know, for projects that have been around since last August or so, this is a good tool to see, you know, where they started at, how high they hit, where they go back down, where they found support. If you're familiar with charts at all or charting, you know that there's support and resistance that will give you an edge on when to enter or exit a play. So if you're looking to get into, you know, any of these plays, let's say it's at 10 Solana floor, but the average price is at like 5 to 6, you might want to wait until it pulls back, and this will help you actually see that visually, so you're not just kind of guessing like, all right, well, this is the activity sold here. You know, it gives you some data to actually back your decision and make a more of an educated decision rather than like a gut feeling, even though a gut feeling could pay out. Like, there's no right or wrong. This is just a tool to help you. Like I said, this is not financial advice. Take it as you will, but we're gonna get right into it and get started now.
All right, so first up, we have Soul Radar. First thing I do when I get on this page, I just kind of check it out when I'm looking around at NFTs, and you can see the collections that they have. It gives you the top 20 and their price action. So you can see this one's up 1,000%. 5,000, it goes all the way down, you know, to 52, 57. So it gives you an idea of, all right, what project is moving, and then maybe that your next step would be get on their Twitter and see why is it moving. What has there been an announcement? Check out their Discord. See, you know, what is the general sentiment going on with this project? Like, Skull Division is a great project. Heard a lot of good things about them. So let's say I was looking into getting into this. All right, so first thing I want to do is check out the floor price. Cool. 0.64, not bad, a good entry point. Looks like it's up 100%, so it looks like something was going on to make this have a nice increase. Maybe there's tokens, maybe there's some kind of breeding, I don't know what they have, but there's something going on to make this run up. The volume's up 434%, and the average sale price is up 32%, so that is a good sign. How long is it sustainable? Those are all questions that you kind of want to ask yourself, and then you can start to find or search for those answers. First thing you do is check magiceden. You check their, you know, the price action going on there. See how quick you see the activity. That's a very important thing when you're looking at when to buy into a project. So you can use these in tandem. So you check out Soul Radar. It's been around for a little bit. Or Skull Division. Check that on Soul Radar. You see it's been around for a little bit. You go out to the week, month, you can see that, all right, maybe this was their mint and everybody sold off to take all their profit, so the floor price dropped down and everybody was, you know, trying to get out. Looks kind of flat, to be honest with you, because I mean, this is only a few days up and down, comes back up, comes back, and then something happened and they've been seeing upward trajectory for the last, you know, week and a half, and you can see the average price up higher than where it was back in January 12th. So that is great to see with the project. Volume through the roof, listed count. It's starting to go down. So just because you see it go up, you got to remember if you had all of the selling pressure right here, or at least, you know, low floor prices and volume comes down, you're going to see the listed count go up. People are trying to get out of it. They think it's, you know, they're going to lose their money. They're getting scared. So once you see this start going down, that correlates with this kind of price action on the charts. So always zoom out, you know, take a look at that. Now, what you would want to do, since you're looking into buy now, go to the 3-day. You can see how it's been the last few days. All right, so there was something there. What I would do is try to figure out what happened on February 1st to make this price run up. And then you'll find out, you know, maybe I hold off, or maybe I get onto this before this rocket takes all the way up, because this could have been the loading stage where it's just getting primed and ready to go. So there could be a bunch of different things. Here's the links down here if you need to go check those out. I'm not going to do those. So the other thing is Peeps. That's their NFT that you would be able to get, and you can get it off of magiceden. You can take a look at their website there. We aren't going to do that. But the reason I'm saying that is they have different, like right here. Your watch list becomes premium soon if you don't own a Peep or a Soul Radar NFT to access that, or you won't be able to access that. So it gives you a link straight to the magiceden. But this is just a list of NFTs that I have that, you know, I was kind of testing this out and seeing the progress. You can see that in the last 24 hours, it doesn't look like they're doing amazing. But remember, if you saw 1,000% increase on a small project like that and it hits the top 20, that could be misleading. You know, some of these are just might be cooling off. 0.63 floor for Wastelanders Mutants, that seems pretty good, because I've seen it, you know, closer to like one Solana, and then undercutters came in, which is absolutely fine. Like, don't ever get me wrong, I think that's, you know, cool to do. Lazy Heroes is pretty much neck and neck with them right now. Two comic book NFTs that I think are going to do great things, guys. So watch out for these Wastelanders, Lazy Heroes. I'm telling you, 2022 going to be some gems. But going to the large collections, this shows you like those really high prices. As you can see, Boryoko Dragons, 300. Floor price there, it's insane. You got Mindfolk out of nowhere. They've only been around for a few weeks. One of my favorite projects. I did a review on these guys. The Degen Coin Flip. I love playing that game. And then you got Exile Degen, Ape Academy, Thug Birds, Monkey Kingdom. So you get to take a look at a good variety of projects. And then, I mean, let's say Stoned Ape Crew is something you want to get into. And I have a terrible story about Stoned Ape. I got in very early, and I sold very early, so I don't get to be part of this, but that is the way it goes. I mean, I made a profit, but you can see that this is a great project. I mean, they're taking off. Social media holders are going up, the volume up and down. Not a lot of people are selling, but when there is a good sale, it's going to make that volume go through the roof because they're high sales. All right, so the average price steadily increasing, floor price steadily increasing. All right, so I sold these at like between 2.5 and 3 Solana, because I got it for like 1.2 or something like that. So I thought I did good. It was one of my first buys. And you can see, 40 Solana. I would have probably sold it before then anyway, so no big deal. But that's Soul Radar, guys. That's kind of how you would look at it, to take a look at the price action and everything like that. And this is the social media that kind of showed you how the metrics are looking on the media end, so, seeing how many followers they're getting. Floor price, I mean, I guess that coincides with it a little bit. They have more followers. The floor price, you know, should show that, but I don't think it correlates that well. Mainly just kind of gives you an idea of how many Twitter and Discord members there are. Because when you're following NFTs, having a community back it really doesn't matter what the floor price is, because in the long term, they tend to do well. Like, look at this one. This is a great example. Baby Ape Social Club. 23,743 followers, 44,460 Discord members, floor price of basically 7 Solana. Total volume the last 24 hours, 628. That is amazing. So you can take a look, check out their charts. Take it back here. That's what I love to do. See floor price. I mean, it's going down, but what, 7, 6, something like that? Solana, average price is down. So the hype's probably just not there for them right now, but It's a great, you know, blue chip project. There's no doubt about it. So, all right, guys, that's Soul Radar. Let's take a look at Soul Sniper. All right, gang, I put up Soul Sniper's website, and unfortunately, there was a technical issue, like a little notification up here saying that they're down, not at full capacity, not as full. The full functionality isn't there. So basically, it is an analytics platform for Solana NFTs. can go to your watch list right here. Adding different NFT projects would show up here, and you can click these and it kind of cycles through them as you would like to see. And typically this is like an active bar that moves. So anytime that there's a drop in the price and you're ready to buy it, you hit snipe the floor, it takes you straight over to Magic Eden, so you're able to do so. And now back at their home screen, it gives you the most tracks collection. So if you're just kind of not sure what you want to get into, it gives you some of the more popular ideas. And what you would do is click on this and go to their, you know, Twitter, Instagram, all of that kind of stuff. Kind of do your own research, see how the project is, look at the roadmap, see if it's something you like. And then down here is featured users. So it has people that are kind of known, I guess, in the NFT space as far as Twitter. And then this guy's on YouTube, another YouTuber. I guess eventually you'll see me posted up here. We'll see. But trending collections is this section down here. It shows you the top ones in the last hour, 3 hours, and 6 hours, the change in the floor price. So the last 6 hours, if you're looking to get into Shadowy Supercoders DAO, that's up 8%. I don't know if that's something you're looking at, but for me, I would be looking for the red ones with down 30%. Why? It's down 30, 19, and then Meta. So Meta Village across the board is down. It looks like it's taking a little bit of a pullback, and you know, if you bought here at this top, you're down 0.7. Or if you buy in right now, you're on a 0.7 discount, whichever you want to look at it, which is about 15.5%. So that's one way to kind of like use this tool to your advantage to see like, hey, maybe I'll get in here if it's a project that you know is a great one and you want to be part of it. That'll give you the edge on finding the best price. So they have their Discord and Twitter links up here as well. But that is, for what we can see, that is Soul Sniper. It's a great tool. Don't knock it because it's down right now. Let them work out their, you know, their flaws or their bugs, and I'm sure it'll be an even better tool when that time comes around. So, hope you got something out of it, guys. But those are the two tools that I would suggest using. If you have any other tools that you like to use or any other, you know, suggestions, put them in the comment section down below. I'll be more than happy to take a look at them. Maybe I'll even do a review on that one as well.
All right, guys, that is a wrap. Thank you for watching the video. If you haven't already, smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel. I do thank you so much for all of your support, as it means the world to me. Like I said, I do apologize for Soul Sniper not being up, so you couldn't see the whole functionality of that website, but it is a great project, and it has helped me get into some positions. And whether you're getting a base hit or a home run, guys, a W is a W. Don't let anybody get you kind of twisted on that. Watch out for the percentages on the NFT for royalties and the artist. But if you're in the green, take your profit if you want to. Don't let anybody say you're paper handing, you're not, it doesn't matter, it's your money. At the end of the day, it is your money and you can do whatever you want with it. Don't even listen to me for advice. I'm just showing you the tools that are available to help you guys get the best entries and exits on these projects, all right? If you have any questions, you have any other tools or any projects you want me to take a look at, put them in the comments down below and I'll get straight to them, guys. Take care of yourselves and be safe.